Okay, so welcome to the new workshop. So sorry if anybody thought that the new workshop was going to be some kind of huge expansive outbuilding like you'd find, you know, in the middle of nowhere in America or something. It is basically a bedroom again in the house, but there is actually quite a little bit more space in here than there was in the old room. So the window here is south facing, which means I'll get good light in here, unlike the other workshop. Obviously it's January at the moment, so you know, the light's still quite dull, but through summertime and so on, I'll get a lot of decent natural light in here, which is good. Obviously, I've got a radiator on this wall here, so that wall's kind of out in terms of units. It's the window wall anyway, so that makes the most sense. So my general plan for here is that there's going to be an L-shaped bench like I used to have, but bigger. So the main piece of bench is going to run along that back wall there, and it'll be for seating height like my old one was, for, you know, sitting and working. And then along this wall here, I'm then going to return the bench but at a higher height. So rather than having one constant level of bench, we're going to go along, jump up, and then come down here. Now, there's two reasons for that. You can't get those low down units anymore from IKEA that I used for the other bench. They don't exist, so I couldn't buy any more if I wanted to. But also, sitting and standing at worktops is two different things. You know, what works for one height doesn't work for the other. I'll talk a little bit more about that when I get the benches installed. That'll give me two different heights, and that'll give me a comfortable standing area and a comfortable seating area, and it should look okay. So I'll be reusing some of the old units there, two of them, and then I'll be buying as close units as I can find to go down here, and then all new worktop. So that should look nice. In the opposite corner of the room there, they're obviously going to be a little bit more space. I don't really want to fix any more units in there because it's going to start to dictate exactly what's in the room. So what I might do is get some kind of a unit on wheels that I can maybe wheel around or move out of the way, or wheel to a different location, or maybe use for filming videos or something like that. I can always sit behind it in the middle of the room and put the camera at the other side, which isn't something you can do with a fixed bench top very easily. So I'll have a think about what's going on there. And then I've obviously got quite a lot of wall space, and I'm going to build some cabinets that you'll see for thread and things like that. I don't really want a lot of wall mounted cabinets because I find it makes the space a bit more claustrophobic. I didn't really like it in the old workshop. There's going to be plenty of storage in here with all the drawers and cupboards and things. So I think I'm just going to keep the walls plain and put some pictures and things on the walls. In terms of the lighting, there's just a single light drop in here at the moment. That's not going to be any good for the workshop. I need to have a look. I don't think I'm going to be able to get cable run in the ceiling for extra lights because I don't have any access upstairs. It's there's not a lot of space to feed cable, so it may be that I have to actually surface mount a little bit of tiny trunking like I did in the old workshop. And what I'll probably do is I'll run across and have a work light here, some kind of LED panel for this taller bench, and then the same at the other side, so possibly a run down to over the other bench. There might be two little bits of trunking on the ceiling. It doesn't look great, but you know, white trunking on a white ceiling, how often do you actually look at it? In terms of the window, you also need to be able to control light in an area. It's good having, you know, it's good having a lot of natural light, but on a very bright day on a south-facing window, that could also be an overbearing amount of light, especially for me because I have problems with my eyes. So I'm planning on getting a double roller blind that they do. So it's basically a roller blind with two rolls on, and you can either roll down what they call a daylight blind, which is where it allows a lot of natural light through and just cuts a little bit out. It's also got the colour blackout blind on, so if it's really too bright and you want to actually shut the light off, then you can roll that one down as well. So it just gets you, sort of get you two things. that's my plan for the window, so that I can cope with that. Or if it's a nice day and I don't need anything at all, I can just open it up. And as you can see, I've got quite a nice view outside the back there of the other houses and so on. This is at the back side of the house. So that should be okay for the window, I think. So that's the general plan for in here. It's going to be getting painted. So I'm just starting now with my filling the bits of holes up and stuff like that. It's going to be painted a nice, I think it's called stone green, the colour that I've chosen. It's sort of quite a light grey-green colour, which should look nice. This carpet needs to come up, and I'll be installing a laminate floor. Obviously, in a leather workshop, you need to be able to sweep up. You don't want, you need to be able to move your wheelie chair around and stuff like that. So laminate floor is still going to be the easiest for that. So get a nice laminate floor, something with some character in it, I think. So yeah, that's the space, and you're gonna watch it come together, hopefully, over the coming weeks. Okay. So if you want to come on that journey, make sure you subscribe, do your notifications and everything, and then you'll see what videos are going to be coming along. Okay, so I hope you've enjoyed having that little first look at the room here, but this whole space will be getting quite transformed over the coming weeks. And then obviously when I get back to proper leather videos, this is where you'll be joining me from going forwards as well. Okay, I'll see you in the next video.